It's now my privilege to introduce the pastor and director of St. Paul's Newman Center, Father James Cheney. Fresh off a small dairy farm in Wolf Lake, Minnesota, he came to NDSU as a student, and he has been here in some ways ever since. Welcome him to the stage. That's what I'm talking about.
Go Bison! The Eye of the Bison. I better not. Thank you all for coming here tonight. You know, Ole Lars and Sven died and they went to the pearly gates of heaven. St. Peter tells them that they can enter the pearly gates if they can just answer one really simple question: what is Easter? And Ole replies, oh, that's easy. It's the holiday in November when everybody gets together and eats turkey and is thankful. Wrong, says St. Peter. He proceeds to ask Lars the same question: what is Easter? And Lars replies, no, Easter is the holiday in December when we put up a nice tree, exchange presents, and celebrate the birth of Jesus. St. Peter looks at Lars, shakes his head in disgust. He looks at Sven, and he asks him, well, what is Easter? Sven smiles, and he looks at St. Pete right in the eye. I know what Easter is. Easter is the Christian holiday that coincides with the Jewish celebration of the Passover. Jesus and his disciples were eating at the Last Supper, and he was later deceived and turned over to the Romans by one of his disciples. The Romans took him to be crucified, and he was stabbed in the side. They made him wear a crown of thorns, and he was hung on a cross. He was buried in a nearby cave, which is sealed off by a large boulder. And every year the boulder is moved aside so that Jesus can come out. And if he sees a shadow there, there'll be six more weeks of winter. What up? Ole, Lars, and Sven, yeah. Those guys. You know what? Many of our young adults are like I was, fresh off a small dairy farm in Minnesota. We worked hard on that farm. And we had religious ed at the parish after Mass on Sunday, but never really learned that much about the faith. So who gets to instruct the direction of our young adults in the college experience today? Who gets that privilege? I'd like to suggest that whoever wants the future generation will have them. We want them. Whoever is willing to fight for the heart and soul of our future leaders, they'll have them. Our young adults and the gift of their Christian heritage and faith are worth fighting for. Curtis Martin, the founder of Focus, has said that the NDSU Newman Center campus ministry program is second to none. That's high praise. Through your partnership, Bison Catholic has been able to build a robust program which attracts students to NDSU, students like Ashton in the video today. These men and women are attracted to the offerings of a large state university like NDSU and provides, at the same time, a Catholic community and a Catholic culture as vibrant as any Catholic university. This only happens when you and I work together to fight for the students. Bison Catholic wouldn't be what it is today without your partnership, without your support. No longer can a student say, where's the Newman Center? Right over there. That's right. You know, in the video, Ashton, he really wanted to take advantage of NDSU's reputation as an outstanding school in engineering. And at the same time, he wanted to be a part of the Cardinal Mitch Men's Hall. The Men's Hall is a component of our faith-based housing, Newman Living, a 501c house of religious formation attached to St. Paul's Newman Center. And it's there to help young men build virtue in their lives. As a freshman required to live on campus, Ashton could not have lived in Newman Living if we had not fought for his religious exemption and First Amendment religious right to do so. After Ashton's first year in college, he and four other guys joined the seminary. We sent five guys to the seminary last year. That's awesome. I don't know what would have happened to Ashton and students like him if you and I weren't there to fight for them. The challenge we face as a people of faith is that the moral and spiritual component of university life is not a priority unless we make it a priority. The university has no plans for addressing the need for character formation, the development of virtue, discerning God's call to make the world a better place with faith-based principles and lives built on prayer. The needs of today's culture, the needs of today's university life are enormous. 41% of all babies are born out of wedlock. The majority of our young men enter the college experience addicted to pornography, with the average age of exposure now being 10 years old. Dating and relationships have been replaced with sort of a hookup culture aimed at immediate gratification. The crisis in religious education leaves students unprepared for making their Catholic faith part of their college experience. In fact, the majority, some 80%, will leave the Catholic faith during their college experience. It's a virtual tsunami, and you and I are there to stop it. When our young adults come to the university, they often are exposed to a worldview that is opposed to what we believe as Catholics. If a young person is questioning the faith as a natural part of the transition into what it means to be an adult, it's our responsibility as a church to give them an equally intellectual reason why their faith is valid and can provide answers in the search for meaning in their young lives. The most important transition in a person's life is not to transition out of home into grade school, out of high school into college. It's the transition out of college into the rest of your life. Young adults make up their minds for themselves what values are going to direction their lives during that college experience. And the Newman Center, with its long history of service to the NDSU campus, is there as a home away from home, where we take the values of your Christian home and make them part of the college experience. We have a comprehensive ministry program. There's something going on at the Newman Center all the time. We had the CFRs there last night. The place was packed. Just did my heart such good. It just filled my heart with such joy just to see so many students taking advantage of that new facility. We've got Bible studies, confession, spiritual direction, adoration, retreats, Knights of Columbus. You know, we're the first Newman Center in the country to partner with the National Catholic Bioethics Center to bring Catholic healthcare ethics certification to a state university. That's pretty cool, you know? What, one in five healthcare workers are going to work at a Catholic hospital. So how do we keep Catholic in the mission of healthcare? We need people who know the teachings of the church. So Bison Catholic is there generating those leaders and providing them with an opportunity to know the church's teaching and engage in a great vocation. Just think, anytime you help someone's body, you help them, right? It's such a beautiful vocation. The fruits of this program have been enormous. We generated about 125 focused missionaries. Think about the chain reaction that's had across the country. Focused missionaries are young adults who commit 2 years of their lives to evangelize college campuses across the country. We sent about 35 guys to the seminary. We've generated about 14 religious sisters and hundreds of marriages. Just marriages. We love marriage. You know? We need marriage so bad. It's always so cute. First they start sitting by each other at Mass, then They can pray better when they hold hands. And prayer and opportunities for leadership promote an authentic self-discovery. A self-discovery during this important period of transition creates an awareness of personal destiny and vocation in the life of Christ Jesus. We can't win the fight for the next generation without you. bisonCatholic, it takes all of us. It takes the body of Christ working to bring the gospel where it's most needed in the world today on that college campus. Tonight, when you partner with us, you join the fight to change hearts, change lives, and form future leaders. The greatest joy and privilege of being a priest involved with campus ministry is working with our young adults and witnessing that transformation and their faith and their lives. I love to plug people into their future and watch them go. It gives me such joy. We have so many tremendous young adults, it gives me a lot of hope. Hope for the future. There have literally been thousands who have graced the doors of the NDSU Newman Center who have been total gifts to us. One of those people is Zeb Wheeler, a peer minister from Jamestown, North Dakota. He's a junior at NDSU, majoring in mathematics. Every week, he goes over the quadratic with me. X equals. I asked Zeb to say a few words tonight about his experience as a young adult at NDSU, so please join me in welcoming Zeb to the stage.